Wait on me.
Yep, we're ready. Rolling.
I seen that. I just checked Facebook. Well,
right, some special guest in here. Old guest.
Yeah, they don't. They can't hear anything going on right now. Probably should have.
Well, we've already started to show Nick's car, so you know what that looks like. Not any good at all. You can see where this frame rail here is probably in a good 4 inches up front. The top hoop bar, shock, all that kind of stuff went over. Actually knocked valve cover off the motor. First time I'd seen that, so that was pretty big. Watered the bay bar up pretty hard. Motor's sitting pretty cockeyed right now. Hoop bar sitting pretty cockeyed. Just went to these laminate windows that actually, it cracked the window at the base there. So I'm not sure what's going on with that. Bends our oil return lines and stuff are right here on the A-frame. When the car hit the wall, it smashed all the oil lines, split them, and that was ultimately why the car caught fire. So biggest thing that hurt this car though, that stuff's manageable, but what really hurts it is when you look inside and you can actually see this frame rail right here. You can see the wrinkle in it. A little right there. You see where this cross member comes in, but cross member comes into the frame rail when that frame rail is wrinkled up. Center section's been bent, hit pretty hard. Man, it's pretty well junk. Not really worth fixing. And it's just a shame because this car was getting to the point to where it was really good for us and good for Nick. We're actually 10th on the board when this happened. I think we probably would end up 12th or 14th by the way practice went. But, just a slow car that was just frustrating. To have that happen, come across the racetrack going as slow as he was, just a real shame. A real shame for us. I mean, we had a lot of work in it, and we were making it better and better each weekend, and it showed as you looked at practice times and race results and stuff. So I'm definitely not the most enthused about what happened here. Obviously, Nick and Tommy are really upset, but just frustrating. But Nick made big gains, and he went right out Friday, and went right up to speed. And I think we were going to be pretty good in the race, as long as we missed all the wrecks at the end. I guess it's good racing if you don't have a car in it.
Well, it's exciting racing anyway, the way it is. So, what a weekend, huh? You know, the best thing about the weekend is the hauler only held two cars. really and truly, golly, we couldn't get anything going on Tuesday. It rained and we was up there tested, had to come back home, go back up. It just, thank goodness we lived close. I can't say enough about, the progress that we made actually this week. On Wednesday, the car kept getting better and better all day long, and then we made a really nice run there toward the end, and he went some 3180s, and the problem that 38, that's right, it was a 3080, and some of the issues that we had with Nick in the past, that it takes him a long time to get back up to speed. We come back Friday and instantly went right back out and got right back up to speed. The track was hotter, it was greasier, it was slicker, and he got right back to speed, and I think at one time we were fourth on the board, and then we fell back to eighth on the board, and just actually out scuffing tires, and wow.
Scuffed up a lot more tires.
Dang, this is not what we needed to have happen, but things like this do happen. Absolutely no fault of Nick's. We've learned some things here. I just actually got off the phone, I called Five Star, because the laminate windshield actually, as you can see at the end, it busted, and that was a little bit surprising. The composite body took a beating. All the driver safety, some of the joy seat is a wonderful piece. I can't say enough about that. Never moved, everything was great. The trough belts absolutely held Nick in. This wreck 10 years ago would probably kill some people. I know it's kind of harsh to say, but that's just the way it is. This time he gets out and he comes back 2 or 3 hours later and gets to race the car. So I can't say enough about the safety stuff. The ARCA deal, the people are getting more and more up on the safety spot. unlike my buddy Brian, so we got our far out, Brian, so. Sorry, Brian.
It wouldn't have made much difference.
No, no, we tore the car up, we didn't burn down, so it was good. But all the safety stuff did its job. Nick come back and we did everything we could, as quick as we could. Just didn't get the car the way it should have been for the night race. And still made an effort. We're getting ready to send the car to Charlotte, down to Timmy's. We'll get the quarter panels fixed on it. We got another one coming back from Scott Tuohy right now, and we'll get ready for Kansas and go from there.
Big shout out to all the guys that come back to shop here, help me get this thing going. Not this thing, the one going over, going to Charlotte, have some body work done on it. We got at the shop, we left the track at 2:05. I remember looking at the clock. Special thanks to Bo. Your mom's calling. We left the track at 2:05 with a motor, and at 10 till 7 we pulled back in with the car, had motor in it, put motor transmission in it, changed 3 springs, and reset the bar, set the heights, set camber on it, and we had to get going. So we got to the track with an hour and 10 minutes left before the race, rolled it through tech, went over it again on ARCA scales, reset our fender height, rear quarter heights, and that was pretty much it.
Thank you to Jimmy and Josh for helping us, you know.
Yeah. Jimmy, Taylor Flip's dad, because he sings the national anthem all the time, and Josh Reed, they come over and help us get things going at the track. We, with the help I had, we were in really good shape when we got to the track because we had a lot of stuff done in the car before we left. So, just pretty awesome. I don't think, there's a lot of people that say they've done that, and for us to do it and have an hour drive each way, to have that much time left over before we got to the racetrack, and nothing fell off the car. The exhaust slipped off. If some people were at the race, they probably heard that the exhaust actually slid back off the header, but we were trying to take the mufflers out and make a little more power. That wasn't as big a deal as the car was just too free for Nick, but man, that's pretty much all we had for the time that we had. We couldn't go sit here and go do a full-blown setup on it.
Other than that, that's about it. So if you need construction needs right now, you guys can see TNT Construction. It wouldn't hurt to shoot a little business that way because we need to replace some parts. So other than that, we'll be back next week or two, and we'll get ready for Kansas.